Captain Salty, and thanks to the new subscribers. Hey, that's pretty cool. And I appreciate the original ones. We're starting to grow slowly. Today we're doing the South China Sea campaign. Can't say China. Well, I just did. Anyway, cast off anchors away. This is my new map. I can't say mine 100% because it's in the cold waters files, but I did find it, and it shows the deep water is blue instead of white, and I think that's what they intended, but they'll probably change it in the future. Also, I added the location names as green, so they're easier to identify, and I made some of the larger fonts more distinct. Okay, we do have a contact. We are in the Seawolf today. Our contact is the Bearing 240.
On sonar, new contact Bearing 24.
Rig ship for ultra quiet.
First thing we do is go to ultra quiet.
Con sonar, new contact Bearing 258. Designated Sierra 2.
Make depth.
Con sonar, new contact Bearing 248. Designated Sierra 3.
We're coming to periscope depth, passing
con sonar,
130
new
feet.
286. Designated Sierra 4.
Now we could ID all these by the signature panel, but I think what we'll do is try to get a surface identification with the periscope ESM mast.
Sierra 4 is classified as merchant.
Well, at least we have one down as a merchant. The range is 10,000 yards. That's what I'm afraid I don't like. Okay, it's nighttime. Nighttime, daytime. Get around to the right or correct bearing.
Con, dive at 4, 5, 8, dive by.
Actually, they're south of us. I don't know what I'm doing up here. Below 270. Oh, I was checking the merchant. This range is 10,000. Not going to fire on the merchant. Just checking range. Turn on night vision here. Below 270, which means more left. Ah. Yeah, now that's more like it. It's like a huge merchant. Huge merchant. Okay, this looks like a battleship. Can't seem to pick him up yet. That must be Sierra 2. There's another big
con sonar
merchant.
Master 3.
Oh, it's
is
a fun game.
Merchant.
He's fair game. He's in yellow or orange. I should say in the lower left hand plot. Should be one more.
Down to go.
Sierra 1 we didn't identify yet. Okay, we have not fired yet, so now we'll go deep. I think we have enough information. We'll go down to 1,000 feet because we do have a sonar ping coming from Sierra 2. That is a warship. By the way, if I didn't say this again, welcome back. We're doing version 1.12 of Cold Waters today. And there are some mods in it. You can find at subsim.com. I have a couple. Actually, I have three. One is the strategic map, and the second one is the location mod, if you will. And the third one is you see our attack panels in the lower left-hand corner are on all the time, which I prefer that. So you can get that all at subsim.com. Just check the forums and check the Cold Waters downloads and go to the graphics section. I should leave a link for subsim.com at the end of this video or below the video. I'm prepping my tubes here, and I have been watching Captain Jive Turkey's videos in anticipation of this release. So I did get some great ideas from him. I appreciate that. Hats off to you, sir. Or salute. You probably like salute with a little vodka.
Make turns for one.
As you can see, what we're doing now is we're turning away from the enemy, showing him our rear end or stern, putting him in our baffles.
Sonar lost contact.
The reason for that is we're going to try to keep these contacts at 10,000 yards or more.
Sonar lost contact. Sierra 2. Last bearing 2-6-6.
So that if they do launch torpedoes or whatever,
Sonar lost contact. Sierra
we have a chance to get
two,
away.
Four.
In other words, evade right or left of the torpedo track. Chengdu looks pretty close.
Yeah,
it's 8,300 yards. I'm trying to see if I can pull away from him by going to 10 knots.
Maneuvering, making turns for 1-0 knots.
And you'll see that we can't.
Lost contact. Sierra 1, last bearing 2-4-4. Contact is in the con helm. Steady course.
I'll alter course just a little bit. Really don't want to go to 15 knots, so I think what we'll do is we'll just slow down and we'll shoot. We're far enough away, yet close enough to fire our torpedoes.
Con, dive at 1000 feet.
Okay, we have
by.
Reached our final depth. Sounds like final destination. Trying
make
15 knots for a second.
1-5 knots. Maneuvering eye. Maneuvering, making turns for 1-5 knots.
As you notice, we still aren't pulling away from him.
Con, torpedo room, tube 5 ready.
Back, they seem to be closing. So I think it's time to, the air surface contacts are fairly quick. Our plan will be to slow down, fire at the three contacts we have, Chengdu, and the Fengyang. Oh, I'm butchering those names, I know, but
maneuvering eye.
It's okay. They butcher our names too. We're going down just
make
a little
depth
bit deeper.
1-2-5-0 feet, dive by. Make depth 1-3-0-0 feet, dive by.
We're ready to fire. And what we're going to do is we'll fire in the contacts.
Con sonar regained contact on master 3 bearing
sonar
2-5-4.
The yellow line's coming to our sub. Okay, we're going to do a fire point procedure on Chengdu and the Fengyang. First torpedo. It's going to be bearing 265. Range to enable 3,000 yards. Let's go.
Shoot 2-1. Aye, sir.
Shoot 2-2. Waiting for a sonar ping from that surface ship. There he is. 253. Snapshot 2-2.
Aye, sir.
And we can
con torpedo room. Tube 8 ready.
We can fire tube 3 as well. Let's put him down there. Towards the... I want to get the further contact. If I can. We need one more torpedo. And we can activate these torpedoes passively. In other words, turn on the listening device in the torpedo. That's what I'll call it. Chengdu. It's like a... I don't want to say the wrong thing, but it looks like it's a story to me.
Shoot 2-3. Aye, sir.
I have not looked up these ships to get the details on them yet. Now we're firing a MOS in that direction just in case. Probably should fire it right down in here. Hopefully, if they fire anything back, they'll pick up the MOS instead of our boat.
Con, dive at 1300 feet, dive by.
Okay, we are at 1300 feet. Reload tube 8. I don't know why that torpedo's so low on the... so deep. That's all right. It'll find the target. That one's up at the surface. I'm going to do something you shouldn't do. I'm going to cross the wires. I can't make up my mind where I want to send these torpedoes. But the two closest contacts are the ones that should be taken out first. So that's why I'm steering tube 3 down to the southern contact. Chengdu, Sierra 1.
Con, fire control, weapon
and
acquired.
And we have locked on. Now we're still staying in passive mode on the torpedoes. If you use...
people,
shouldn't say it that way,
ready.
But... followers that watch these videos, the new ones, are not familiar with the game, the torpedo has an active sonar that you can turn on, and the torpedo will ping off the its contact, its target. Right now they're operating passively, which means they have their listening device on. You can see that in the sort of the triangular cone, but they're not pinging the target, which means that target should not know that the torpedo is coming. Chengdu being closer than it appears and has already acquired with tube 2, what I'm doing now is steering tube 3 again across the wire to the Fengying.
Weapon acquired.
He's acquired on the same contact. We'll steer it away. See that quick turn?
Con, sonar, lost contact. Sierra 2.
I hope
last
you did.
Bearing two,
when
six,
you see a
seven,
fast turn on a torpedo,
up.
That means it's close to the contact and it's homing in, and the contact basically is sunk. Reload 2-1. Now this being a nighttime attack, I'm afraid it's just a little bit too dark. Apologize for that, but there's nothing I can do about it. But we will see some surface attacks in this video. And you can see the detailing and the modeling done by Killerfish. It's amazing. And oh, by the way, this video is done. Captain X is working on... Okay, he's done. Captain X, the modder, is working on the new playable subs mod for the South China Sea. And once he's released that, we'll put that in the game along with our mods. And should be an overall load of fun. What he does is he adds more subs. More subs, American subs.
Con, torpedo room, tube one ready.
So you can take out different boats or what have you, and he adds more enemy ships as well. So there's a lot of content in this game, and Killerfish encourages us to, add the mods if we'd like. They're not cheap mods. They're just something to make the game easier to manage and control. Now you're going to see something here. Let's get back to the game. You're going to see something here. This Chengdu, actually what is happening here is that Tube 3 is homing in. I'll let you in on a secret. It's homing in on the merchant. And the Feng Ying down at the south of the Tube 3 is our actual contact. But we'll figure that out. And in time. Now we're turning towards target. Take some tension off the wire. The wire, as you know, comes out the bow, comes out the torpedo tube. So instead of driving away from that torpedo, we're driving towards it so that you take some tension off that wire. And the other reason is there's only one enemy ship left that I can see at this point. So it's pretty safe to say we can sail towards instead of running away. We're not really running away. We're positioning ourselves for attack. You'll see sooner or later I'll realize that this Tube 3 here is not going in the correct direction. It's doing its job, it's homing in, but it's homing in on a merchant instead of the other surface contact. And there's the surface. I don't know if you can see it, but that, you can see it now. There's a ship to the south of the torpedo, so we'll turn towards it. I believe that is our real target. And we'll steer it till it starts homing and loses its lock on the merchant. Okay. Now the contact on the plot in the left shows it a little more to the right of the, I'm sorry, to the left of the torpedo, but that plot is not 100% accurate. Reason being, it's just information that is better confirmed by the torpedo and its sonar. You know, it's approximate. It's telling you there's a contact out there that's about where it is, but not exactly. There's a... Oh, I don't want to pronounce it the way I want to. This is a friendly channel. But I'll call it a Feng Ying for now. I think that's a nicer term for it. Not accurate, but that's what we call it. It's a large, probably supply ship. It has munitions on board. So it's fair game. We are locked in. We're being actually from the torpedo. And he's going to be boom in a second.
Con, sonar lost contact. Master, 3. Last bearing, 2, 4, 5.
One ship down. It's safe to leave combat, so we will. We sunk three ships. Used three torpedoes. That's pretty good. And we did fire one MOS. Okay, that was a successful mission. But let's do one more and see what happens. Now, this video is going to be a little bit longer today, and that's probably to make up for the fact that I haven't posted in a while. I was waiting for 1.12 to come out, which isn't good for the channel, but it's good for you guys. I hate to post videos of the older version of Cold Waters in the Norwegian Sea when, you know, some, let's say, privileged, that's right, privileged streamers get the new version of the South China Sea. In other words, who's going to want to watch the Norwegian Sea when they can watch the South China Sea? So, in any case, not a problem. There's our sub. Okay, we're going to come down towards the Spratly Islands, because that's where our mission is going to be. And we'll position ourselves right about here. And wait, and wait, and no, I'm just kidding. We don't have to wait too long. This is going to be an action-filled game, if you will. In other words, we don't have to wait long between missions or contacts, or here we go. Two surface contacts. We'll deal with the first one first. All hands manned battle stations. We have a sonar contact, Marine 287. Designate Sierra 1. We're doing 5 knots, 50 feet. Let's go to battle stations, guys.
On sonar, new contact.
Rig ship for ultra quiet.
Go to ultra quiet first. That's another new strategy
sonar,
or tactic
new
from
Jag
Turkey. I think it's a good one.
Sierra, two.
While you're IDing boats, stay at
con sonar, new
ultra
contact
quiet.
Bearing, 302. Designated Sierra,
World
three.
War II, they called it silent running.
Con sonar.
Make depth 4-5 feet, dive by.
We're coming up to periscope depth.
Con, dive at 4-5 feet, dive by.
And we'll do a...
Raise the ESM mast. Upscope.
Okay, we're going to take a look. Hopefully this is at daytime. Yes. Good. And this is for you guys. I'd rather attack at night, but I do like the daytime attacks as well, because I can see the ships easier. Okay, we're just getting into distance and direction for the periscope. I should have done that first.
Con, torpedo room, tube 3 ready.
And we're looking through a scope. We're trying to come to the bearing of the enemy ship. Master 2. There he is. But too far away to identify. You can see him. He's right in the crosshairs. Okay, now what we should do, he's far enough away. Let's prepare our torpedoes. Set our course, turn away.
Come right to 111 helm I.
Even though they're at 32,000 yards, that can't be 100% accurate. Now let's try to confirm these IDs, identifications. We have a Luda 3.
Con sonar, Master 1 is classified as escort.
And Master 2. Master 2, what are you?
Con sonar, Master 2 Zhang is
Wei.
Classified as escort.
Sierra 4, what are you? Could be a merchant. Oop. Could be. Yeah, it is. A merchant. Okay.
Con sonar. Sierra 4.
Let's do Sierra 3 while we're here. Things are quiet and calm. Well, we're coming to our intended course. Looks like another merchant, but I'm not positive. Oh, it's a trawler.
Con sonar, Sierra 3 is classified.
Okay, now
as
the Luda
merchant
is closest, so we'll focus on it. We'll make sure our course is correct.
Come right to 125 Helm I.
And let's start to prepare for our attack. These are surface contacts, so we'll set our torpedo to surface, which is the up arrow. Pardon me. And is it 31,000 yards? But he's heading towards us, so we might do 16,000 yards.
Tube 1, aye, sir.
Fire tube 1 and fire tube 2.
Shoot tube 2, aye, sir.
Firing point procedures. And should we use the mouse now?
Con, helm, steady course.
Now we're activating these torpedoes passively, which means we're turning on their listening device. And they do have their own sonar, which we won't turn on because that'll give away the attack. When we operate passively, basically what happens is
make depth 300 feet, dive by.
Now, what I'm trying to do here is sink out. In other words,
make turn.
Negative
make
ballast,
turn four,
but
one,
keep the ship
five,
level.
Sonar. We are cavitating.
And I hit the wrong button and go to cavitate.
ESM mast has been damaged.
And one thing leads to another, it damaged the ESM mast. Now I need to slow down.
Back emergency, maneuver guide.
And repair
con
the ESM mast.
Contact on, master. Make turns 4, 5 knots. Maneuvering up.
Not so bad, right?
Con sonar lost contact. Master 1. Last bearing 2, 8, 4. Contact is in the baffle.
But it turns out to be a little
con,
bit more involved than I thought. Now there's
knots.
The ESM mast.
Damage control parties. Into the torpedo room.
Damage control
con
will fix that.
Regained contact on. Master 2. Bearing 3.
But
0.
Lesson
zero.
Learned. After you fix the ESM mast, don't forget
feet.
To lower it, because it's still up. You'll see that's what I do, so I have to repair it twice.
Regained contact on Sierra 4, bearing 3,
and
zero,
yes, this is
five.
Kind of a voiceover, because, well, for a couple of reasons. One, my mic adjustments, I wanted to make sure those were correct, and the second one is the fact that
make turns 4, 0 knots, maneuvering eye.
You know, a live voiceover, if you will, or a live, you know, discussion while we're attacking can be a little bit confusing. Again, I hope I mentioned this before. If I didn't, I can't recall. This is going to be a little bit longer video today because it is the new South China Sea campaign.
The ESM mast has been repaired.
Okay, now watch. The ESM mast, we're doing 5 knots.
Make turns 4, 5 knots.
It's repaired, but it's in a darker black font over in the right-hand damage control panel, which means it isn't 100%, but it's functional. But right now I forget to lower it. And there's the torpedoes right off the Zhanghui. Looks like an airdrop, and there's another airdrop coming towards us.
Turns 4, 3, 5.
So here's where I make a mistake.
Con, sonar, lost contact. Master, 1. Last bearing, 2, 8, 4. Contact is in the baffles.
Con, fire control, we've lost the wire.
Con, ESM master, with damage.
I did it again.
Back emergency, maneuvering eye.
Back emergency, that's the quickest way to slow down the boat. Take the stress off the ESM mast.
Make turns four, five, nine.
Okay, guys, you did it before I do it again. Damage control and torpedo.
Making turns 4, 5 knots.
Control tower, whatever. And I'm compressing time here, speeding up. Try to get this repair done quickly. And then we'll go to our boat view, our own ship view, and you can watch me lower the ESM mast.
The ESM mast has been repaired.
Okay. Okay, there's our ESM mast now.
Lower the ESM mast.
There you go. That's the way to do it. And we have these little torpedoes, I call them bullseyes. I don't know what they are. And what I will do is I get more familiar with the South China Sea campaign is to get more information on the enemy torpedoes. I'm told the yellow ones are dangerous and the green ones aren't that bad. Reason being, no, I'm talking about the enemy torpedoes. The yellow ones have a cone that looks up and down when it's searching, as well as side to side. The green ones look side to side, you know, in its search. So in other words, if you're at 1,200 feet and you're more susceptible to be discovered by the yellow torpedo than the green torpedo. And that's one way to evade. These are airdrop torpedoes, so they shouldn't be too bad.
Con, fire control, weapon countermeasure homing.
Pretty sure they are airdropped. They're small, so I think that's what's going on there. We're reloading two. My running commentary. This one's in a hurry. 31 knots. I'm sorry, 31 yards. 31 knots as well.
Con, sonar, lost contact. Sierra, 4. Last bearing, 3. 0, 6, contact faded.
Kind of a large. I'm turning on active sonar, if you notice that, on tube 1. But I'm steering it, so it really didn't use the sonar.
Con, sonar, lost contact. Master, 1. Last bearing, 2. 8, 8. Contact breaking up.
Today we're running on
Con, sonar, lost contact. Master,
you can see
two,
the other ship blow up in the
three,
distance.
0, 0. Contact
Take
breaking
behind.
Up.
There it is. Zhanghui. So we have two enemy warships down. One, I believe, is a destroyer. Again, I didn't look these up yet, but I will. What is a larger warship? I don't know. If it's a cruiser or what? This one here looks to be a destroyer. Luba 3 is larger.
Make turn.
And actually, that's two down. And that's all we have. So right now we'll reload to one, we'll accelerate time. To get away from the
Calling torpedo room, 2-1 ready.
And also to speed up our load-up time, I will leave combat. Sunk two ships. Not our mission target. Okay. Not a problem. Plenty of food on board. Okay, we have a new contact, bearing 298. Our depth is 50 feet.
Sonar, new contact.
Rig ship for ultra quiet.
First we go to ultra quiet. Now I'm not going to show you the ship from the surface.
Sonar, new contact bearing.
I don't want to spoil
two,
it all.
7, designated Sierra 2.
Watch that emergency dive. Don't click
on
that.
Sonar, new contact.
Make depth 4, 5 feet, dive by.
We're coming up to 4 or 5 feet. We're going to raise the periscope. They're at 11,000 yards. We're going to turn away.
Helm right 2. 1, 3, 2. Helm I.
We're already getting a sonar ping from those two ships, Sierra 1 and Sierra 2. Trying to figure out what to do here, but the course of action, I think we really should raise the periscope. Set these torpedoes to surface. See if we can make an identification from the sonar man. Pardon me. There we go. Jane
Con
Lee.
Sonar, Sierra 2, is classified as escort.
Sierra 1. It's a Luda, DDG.
Sierra 1, is classified as escort. Con Sonar, we are cavitating.
Oops.
Con
Too
Sonar,
close to the
no
surface.
Longer cavitating.
So we'll do a snapshot and
shoot tube 3. Aye,
tube
sir.
Tube 3 and tube 2.
Shoot tube 2. Aye, sir.
Only because we cavitated for a second. Which was my bad.
Con maneuvering, making turns for.
And activate
five,
both
nine.
Torpedoes. Passively, of course. For now. And we'll go deep, really I shouldn't do it this way, I should just sink out. So I take the planes, set the planes back to zero, and the ballast will set those to negative 30.
Con. Make turns.
So basically
we're not maneuvering
letting the air out of the ballast tanks, flooding them.
Passing 100 feet.
Now the reason we're doing that is we're trying to get away from any possible incoming torpedoes or MPA or helos dropping torpedoes.
0 knots. Maneuvering eye. Con maneuvering. Making turns.
I mean, if you're at
one,
the surface at periscope depth and they drop a torpedo, you don't have much room to maneuver. But if you're at 9,000 feet, obviously you do.
Passing 200 feet.
Because it takes them a while to come deeper. Again, if you're new to the game, don't hesitate. The first link you want, honestly, there's two links. First link you want, subsim.com. And register there, it's free. And once you register, you can download, you can visit the forums, you can ask questions, what have you. It's a great place to go. All the mods are there. I've got one, two, three, I think three at this point. One, two, three. Yeah, three mods so far. They're all graphics mods, if you will. Make the game easier to play, in my opinion. Captain X, again, put some grip mods in there. Just looking at downloads and cold water section.
On Sierra 2, bearing 323. Con sonar regained contact on Sierra 3, bearing 286.
And the other good channel to go to, of course, is Jive Tech. I don't want to take any of you guys away from here, but watch his as well. Just, you know, if you visit here and you enjoy yourself, or you learn something, or you don't, you know, just hit the like button if you can, or subscribe is more important. It just lets me know that, you know, this is worth doing. And believe me, these videos take a long time. For example, if this one is over an hour, which it will be, you record the video, okay, while you're playing it, let's say for an hour. Then you have to go in and edit the video and add commentary, or at least edit the video. That takes you another hour to go through it, and then you have to process it, so that's another hour at least. What do you mean by process? You have to put it all together. With PowerDirector or one of the other programs, and then of course you have to you have to go through another process with Handbrake, which is a great tool, which compresses the video to upload to YouTube. Otherwise, it would take forever to upload an hour video.
Con, fire control, weapon acquired.
Hope I didn't lose you there, but I want to let you know that it does take a long time. It's a lot of effort, so we do appreciate a subscription. It's free. It doesn't cost you anything. Doesn't pester you. You know, just lets me know that you enjoy the channel, and you know, you want to keep these videos coming. So thank you. There's a ship in the distance in the center. Zhang.
Come left to.
Excuse me, Zhang Hui is down, and we have one left, and he's locked in with our torpedo. So what I'm doing is I'm turning toward target, take some pressure off the wire.
Passing,
if you don't know, the
feet.
Wire comes out of the torpedo tube, and if we're traveling away
Con
from
sonar,
our torpedo, that's kind of
two,
stress
nine.
Make depth 850 feet, dive by.
On the wire itself. So if you turn towards the target, you know, it takes attention off the
Con, fire control,
wire.
Weapon acquired.
I'm not automatically, but I am reloading tube 3.
Con, torpedo room, tube 3 ready.
Pardon me. We had a lightning storm down here in South Florida. Lightning storm, is that what you want to call it? Thunderstorm? But one lightning strike hit about a
weapon countermeasure homing.
Quarter mile away. Shook the house. I thought the power was going to go out, but it didn't. But I was out on the patio.
Fire control, weapon acquired.
That was a surprise. It was kind of like that happening to you.
Sierra 1.
Well, it wasn't
nine,
a direct hit, so I guess I made up better than this ship did. And look at that, we have a panel from the interior of the ship hanging out. We blew some wall out. Either wall or walking or platform. And like I said, I like these daylight missions because you can at least see the ships, and they're there in the distance. Snook never saw us. Never counter-fired. Leave combat. The reason they didn't counter-fire is not because it's on easy level. I have it on realistic, as I mentioned, or if I didn't, I will now. And we have another. Let's check this. Okay, Spratly Islands, we're in the right place. We'll come a little bit. Oh, the MPA found us. Military patrol aircraft. They know we're there. They know we're here. So here we have, hopefully, our mission target. But probably not. This could be a group sent over here to get us out of the way.
Contact bearing 3.
Rig ship for ultra quiet.
Con, sonar, new contact bearing 254, designated Sierra 2.
This is an interesting little skirmish, and you'll see why in a couple of minutes. At least it turns out to be. You only have one contact so far, but looks like.
Con, sonar, new contact bearing 10.
Looks like a merchant,
designated Sierra 3.
No, it's not.
Con,
sonar, it's an LST.
Sierra 1 is classified as merchant.
Now, that's a fair target because that's a landing ship. Well, in World War II, we called it a landing ship tank. I don't say we because I wasn't in that war at all. But anyway,
it's basically a support ship.
After the initial landing, they bring in some extra trucks, Jeeps, tanks, what have you. After they make or establish a beachhead.
Con, torpedo room, tube 2 ready.
Looks like an oil rig. I think it is.
Con, sonar, Sierra 3 is classified as.
So we have a landing ship, an oil rig. There should be a warship out here. Don't know where. Can we do a snapshot on the LST? Sure. Bearing 330. Firing report procedures. Range to enable 2,000 yards.
Shoot 2-1. Aye, sir.
Shoot 2-1.
Con, fire control. Weapon acquired.
Why? He's only 4,000 yards away. And we do know there's subs in the area. We haven't found them yet, but we'll get this one out of the way. See what develops from there.
Con, sonar, new contact bearing 20.
Sierra 4.
Designated Sierra 4.
The submissions, you'll find that that looks.
Con, sonar, Sierra 4 is classified
as
Ming. Submerged submarine.
We'll do a snapshot on him, bearing 202.
Aye, sir.
Passively activate our torpedo. What I was saying is our submissions, you'll find, are a little bit closer than surface contacts because they can sneak in on you. So you need to be a little bit more careful than you do, usually, with surface missions. Set that to surface, that was my error. That torpedo, surface search, even though we have them.
Con,
he's toast.
Con, sonar lost contact. Sierra, 1. Last bearing, 3-3-0. Contact breaking up.
Waiting for tube 2 to acquire. Let's reload tube 1.
Come left.
Turn
two,
towards.
Two, zero,
we don't
three,
want to give him our broadside. I mean, if we show him the side of our boat, it's easier for him to counter-detect us.
Con, fire control,
we
weapon
go.
Acquired.
Turning back towards. These torpedoes tend to, once they acquire the target, they tend to turn away and come back, make sure it's the right, you know, contact, blah, blah, blah. But sometimes they turn back on your own ship. And I'll tell you, outrunning a Mark 48 is not impossible, but stressful. I mean, I've done it before, but it's not a pleasant experience to have your own torpedo. Because these Mark 48s are really, really good. Strong duck layer, and we are on the opposite side of it, so that's cool. He doesn't, it's hard for him to detect us.
Con, sonar, lost contact. Sierra, 4. Last bearing, 2-0-6. Contact faded.
So, we'll see what
Con,
a Ming
sonar,
looks like.
Noisemaker, bearing,
oh,
2-0-6.
He knows he's being attacked. So, we'll turn on the active sonar. And what we're doing right now is we're manually steering this torpedo back towards target. There we go. The noisemaker was trying to confuse the torpedo, but we're trying to help the torpedo out a little bit. Goodbye. Down she goes, 2,000 feet.
Con, sonar, Sierra 1 is classified as.
Okay, accelerate
emergency.
Time here to load tube
Con,
2.
Con, torpedo room, tube 2 ready.
I wonder if that's it. Yes, it is for this not mission, but for this engagement. Not our mission objective. That was just a submarine sent in to sink us, basically. I think. Is this our final contact? Okay, bearing 068.
Con, sonar, new contact.
Rig shift for ultra quiet.
First thing we do is we go to ultra quiet. Especially with a submarine. Oh,
Con,
look,
sonar,
we found
new
a whale.
Contact bearing 193, designated Sierra 2.
What Killer Fish has done here is
Con, sonar, new contact bearing
even when
one,
you're
four,
trying to
two,
ID a different contact,
Sierra 3.
If the whale's close enough, you can hear it.
Con, sonar, new contact bearing 097,
which is kind of cool.
Sierra 4. Con, sonar, new contact bearing 204, designated Sierra 5. Con, sonar, Sierra 1 is
Sierra
classified
one is
as biologic.
That's a lot of contacts, which in a way is good. Okay, Song, it's a submarine. Oh no, it's a Romeo.
Con, sonar, Sierra 4 is classified as submerged submarine.
Sierra 5 is really close. Sierra 2 is really close. So I'd like to do those first, but as you see, the closest ones might be okay. We'll find out shortly. And I can see where it's a merchant. Yeah,
Consonar,
you're the whale.
Sierra 2 is classified as
that's
merchant.
Really cool. This looks like a merchant. That's a trawler.
Consonar Sierra 5 is classified as merchant.
Okay, right here, I'm trying to ID Sierra 6, but I should have gone to Sierra 3 because it's the closest contact that we haven't ID'd yet. And could be a potential threat. I always ID the closest contacts first. Let's see, because
Sierra
6 is an oil rig. No threat at all. Now I want to fire at the Romeo.
Come right to 1-1-2.
So I turn right.
No,
as you notice, I have not ID'd Sierra 3 yet. Now, and I go to 10 knots. Showing the broadside of my ship to Sierra 3.
Con maneuvering, making turns for 1-0 knots.
Probably realized that I missed Sierra 3 and IDing that first.
Con sonar regained contact on Sierra 5, bearing 199. Con sonar regained contact on Sierra 2, bearing 212.
And watch what happens from my mistake of not IDing Sierra 3. Oh, now I see it. Snapshot on the Romeo. Firing point procedures. Bearing 105. Range to enable 11,000 yards.
Shoot
2-1.
Aye, sir.
I shoot 2-1 and immediately I get a shot from
con
Sierra
sonar.
3.
Sierra 2 is con sonar. Launch transit from
bad.
Sierra 3.
I launch at Sierra 3, a snapshot.
Fire control, unable to fire.
Activate. Now we're going to get out of dodge.
We are cavitating. Come left to 012, helm I. Con sonar lost contact. Sierra 3,
that's
last
a nasty
bearing
sub
141, contact faded.
Shame on me.
Con sonar lost contact. Sierra 2. Last bearing 2-3-4. Contact is in the baffles.
But if you make a mistake,
con sonar regained
it could cost you your boat.
Sierra 2, bearing 2.
Make depth 700 feet. Dive by.
Con sonar lost
now,
contact.
What I'm doing
Sierra
now is all ahead flank cavitate to the north east and going down to 1100 feet. Let's reload tube 1 and 2.
Con sonar, no longer cavitating.
Always reload your tubes when you can think of it. After you fire them. So that you have a full complement of weapons. Now here I decided to go
right to
90 degrees to the incoming torpedo's track.
Con sonar lost contact. Sierra 2.
I want to get it out of his
two,
target
three,
acquisition
zero. Contact
zone.
Within the baffles.
And you can see the yellow ping
Con, helm,
from the south, southeast. You want to be 90 degrees to that. Yeah, you're showing the broadside of your ship, but you're also, if he's far enough away, you're getting out of his acquisition cone.
Con, maneuvering, making turns for 3-5 knots.
Okay, so we're running at 1,100 feet, or 1,100 feet.
Con sonar regained contact on Sierra 3, bearing 1.
Make turns for 5 knots.
And I slow. I want to see where my torpedoes are going, and see where his torpedoes are.
Con sonar regained contact on Sierra
5, bearing 2. That's our torpedo, where my cursor
two,
is.
1-0.
That was the one fired at the
Con sonar regained contact main. On Sierra 1.
But
bearing,
as you can
one,
see from his
two,
track, he's
seven.
Further north of that our torpedo. So we'll probably do another snapshot. And the sub in the east. It looks like our torpedo in yellow down there is right
Con
on Sierra 3.
Regained contact on Sierra 2, bearing
and look
two,
at that.
Four,
his torpedoes
two,
were fired in
two,
anticipation.
Three, one, seven, helm, I.
They're the green ones in the center, and they're headed north.
Con,
right where we would have gone.
Two, ready.
So I turned away.
Con, maneuvering, making turns for 5 knots.
Snapshot on the main. Bearing 110, range to enable 3,000. Yeah, 110.
Con sonar lost contact. Sierra 3, last bearing 154. Contact breaking up.
Plot course away.
Come left to 305. Helm I.
I come left, but as you'll see or find out, I didn't come exactly 90 degrees to that torpedo, incoming torpedo. I didn't turn away 90 degrees to the torpedo's course, and you see what happens. I was more concerned about not losing the wire at this point.
Con, fire control, weapon acquired.
Torpedo is, I believe, homing in on the humpback whale. Poor guy. They shouldn't do that, but that's okay. Just part of the game. At this point, they'll fix it.
Con, sonar. Torpedo in the water. Torpedo in the water. Bearing 107.
Okay, watch the torpedo closest to our ship.
Con, helm,
I'm trying to steer this
course.
Around the humpback whale. There we go. He's making a circle, which means he's sniffing us out. here he comes. Okay. All ahead, flank cavitate.
3, 5, 9.
Torpedo evasion. Now he's found us, which means that,
Con sonar lost contact. Sierra 4, last bearing 1.
Which means
two,
that he's at our depth.
Contact is in the baffles.
Con, fire control, we've lost the wire.
Good luck with that torpedo. And here's the incoming enemy torpedo behind us. We'll drop a decoy. Now these, I'll call them for now green torpedoes. The one that's attacking me, again, have a side-to-side vision, if you will, but not so much on depth.
Passing 1,100 feet.
So we're going to try to come to the surface.
Passing 1,000 feet.
See if we can lose them. We dropped a decoy
passing
first.
Passing 900 feet. Passing 800 feet. Con, knuckle formed.
Did form a knuckle, try
passing
to confuse
600
him.
Feet. Passing 500 feet.
Con sonar, we are cavitating.
Con,
torpedo is
form.
Coming up.
Con sonar, no longer cavitating.
And don't dismiss the green torpedoes, they can be very deadly. As you'll see, he's avoiding, or he will avoid our noisemaker and our knuckle.
Con, maneuvering, making turns for.
Con, sonar, we are cavitating.
We're turning towards.
Con,
now
sonar,
he has,
lost.
See,
con,
he ignored
form.
Our knuckle and our noisemaker. He's coming right towards
passing
us.
Passing 200 feet.
Again, they can't
passing
change step.
Feet.
As quickly as we can. There we broached.
Con sonar lost contact. Sierra 2. Last bearing 2, 3, 8. Contact is in the baffles.
Passing 100 feet.
Look at that. He avoided the decoy.
Con knuckle formed.
When he tried to get us, it was
passing
so close.
300 feet.
It was a valid effort. Now we'll turn
passing
back towards.
Con sonar, no longer cavitating.
Now he's making a circle. That's a good sign.
Passing 600
that'll
feet.
Give us some time to get below him.
Passing 700
below
feet.
His acquisition cone.
Passing 800 feet.
And we'll know if that worked.
Passing 900
if he makes
feet.
Another circle.
Passing 1,000 feet.
Now he's coming back
passing
towards us.
Feet.
Now if he locks on, we'll just deal with it again, but if he makes a circle, it means we get away with it.
Passing 1,200 feet.
He's making a second circle. Okay, good.
Make turns four.
Now
make
I'm slowing
turns
down.
Four. 1, 0 knots. Maneuvering eye. Make turns four. 5. Knots, maneuvering eye.
And I'm below him, and he doesn't pick me up because he's at the surface. He's circling around our old noisemaker.
Con sonar regained contact on Sierra 1, bearing 1, 4, 2.
It's very attractive to our noisemaker. That's cool.
Come right to 1, 1, 8. Helm
high. And we did sink the enemy sub, the Romeo, and Sierra 3, whatever kind of sub that was, but it was an enemy. Now we can block
come
course
right
away.
1, 0, 9, helm high.
And we'll accelerate time so we can end this mission.
Making turns 4, 5 knots.
And you'll see the closing screens in a second. But again, thanks for coming back to the channel. I hope you enjoyed this little mission today. It'll get more interesting. We're going to do a complete campaign
come left two,
in the
zero,
Sea Wolf.
Eight,
9, Helm I.
Unless we get sunk. But I doubt it. I hope not.
Con, Helm,
and we'll try to make the missions a little bit shorter. But again, this first one, I want to make it longer so that you guys can enjoy the South China Sea campaign and what it's all about. So again, this is Captain Salty, and hopefully we'll catch you next time. And again, it's Monday, so we'll try to get some missions out, or another mission out this week.
I'll
try to do at least two a week, if not
contact
three.
Is in the baffle.
So thanks again. Still weapons nearby, so we still have compressed time and runaway. Then we can end the mission. We'll see the final results. So I'll be quiet and let you watch the end of this. It's Captain Salty signing out. The closing screens you might want to look at. Shouldn't be too long. We're almost there. Or we can end the mission. Yes, we can end the mission. Thanks again, guys. Catch you next time. Again.